You don't know. You don't know how I feel. That used to be a song back in the 60s. But anyway, here I am in the basement. I'm at the desktop today. This is my kind of quilt studio, crochet, any knitting space that I share with my husband, who is usually just contained over here in the corner at the desktop. So we're going to have a few segments today. I have a few finished objects, one mofo that I want your opinion on so I can get it completely finished. Would love your feedback. Also, quite a bit of works in progress. Works in progress. I do have some. And I'm going to talk about in the process of meeting one of my goals that I set for this year. And wait a minute. Notice the makeup? Yeah, I was feeling a little blue yesterday and got up this morning and my daughter did my makeup. She said, do your makeup. So after that, I was like, I gotta put on earrings. I never do this when I'm just here in the house. But, so I just want to recognize her and thank her. Hi, Mo, for being kind enough to fix Mama up. I do have show notes, so if you see me glancing over this way, that's what I'm doing, trying to stay on track. excuse me. I do have a little update on where I'm going with my socks, and talk about a few podcasts that I've been checking out this week. Like I said, I spend a lot of time watching podcasts. I don't have a full-time job, I decided to kind of spend this time that I have trying to create, trying to craft and make things and create. So that's where I'm at, and I'm going to talk a little bit about pulmonary hypertension, which is the reason that I wear the oxygen, and that has been causing me some issues ongoing. So it's kind of hard. I think it's going to be difficult for me to say, depending on how I do with the seasonal allergies, etc., etc. That's coming. Spring's coming. But how often I'm going to podcast. I know I'll at least get to you once a month, twice a month. My goal was to do three times a month. Twice a month still feels like I'm pushing it in the face of some health challenges. But one thing I have is back bounceability. So I'm going to talk a little bit about what pulmonary hypertension is a little, and I hope you'll be curious enough to go check it out and find more information. That's what I'm gonna do. So let's get this party rolling.
Finished object.
I decided, I took on a whim. I said, I know the march is over. But I thought I wanted a hat. I needed a pussy hat. So this is my knitted version. So this is it, and it's not perfect. I forged through, dropped some stitches. The seam here, kind of loose on that side. This side seems to be a little bit better, but I just continue to go through. It was, of course, it's very easy because you knit it flat, and I experimented with a bind off I wasn't familiar with. I think on this side you can kind of see it curling a little bit, and I have a book that I ordered, which I had received, and it was called, I don't know, 40 Ways to Cast Off and Bind, Cast On and Bind Off, and I can't think of what version this was, but it created a little flip out on the whatever you bind off, and the hat was already fitting kind of loose. So I just went back to the bind off, the basic bind off on this. So this is my one finished object. Yes, and I did say one. I know it's been a while, but I've been trying to, you know, just manage. I have a lot to do and manage with my health, and I was just trying to manage and daily life. But anyway, the sweater for my granddaughter. This is the mofo. I need to add buttons on this side. Yeah, I need to add buttons here. These are the buttonholes where the strings are. And she probably won't get much wear out of it. Let's do this again. I'm trying to choose between buttons for this. I was at Joann's yesterday, and they had buy one, get 50% off, or buy one, get one free. I'm trying to choose between the buttons out of here. Oops. Can't move it over from the glare. See, the orange and the pink is in there. I think there's a purple back in there. I wouldn't use the green, but I think it's enough in here. Where I could pick and do that. The other thing I thought is using these three. There's five buttonholes. And this is a gradient pack. So I do have some choice in terms of trying to pick the right purple and pink and orange. And so what do you think? These buttons? Sorry for the lighting. Like I said, this is low budget here. Okay, or this one. The little flower petals. Leave your suggestions in the comment section. I would appreciate that. And let me go back and say welcome. Welcome. If you're a new viewer, I know there are tons of podcasts out here that you could watch. We all know that. And for those who are in the Yarnhead podcast world. And, you know, if you kind of just... You know, I'm nothing fancy, nothing schnazzy here, but I just like to keep it rolling and keep it moving. So, you know, maybe there's something here we can connect. If not, I'll see you later. Maybe we'll bump into each other on Ravelry or Instagram or. So, if you're a returning viewer and a subscriber, I love you. So, welcome back. And I'm your host, Karen Davis, a.k.a. Karoda. Karoda 2, as in the number 2 on Ravelry and StudioKaroda. That name is a carryover from my quilt studio days. But StudioKaroda on Instagram. And I do have a StudioKaroda page on Facebook, but I'm not as active as I used to be. But you know, you can find me. We can holler. We can, you know, hang. So anyway, I'm a person that loves slang. I love dialect. I love accents. Voices, different voices, and anyway, but one of the things, I do love slang, and My kids used to keep me updated, but now that they are in their mid-20s, they don't use slang like they did when they were teens or even early 20s. So I don't know what's really popular out there, but I used to love, you know, learning new slang and then using it on them. And of course, that used to make them go, oh, please, please don't. You know, I think I used something the other day and it was totally inappropriate. Oh, that the phrase, make it rain, which I saw on some, I think I heard it in a rap video or something, and then on some ambulance chasing lawyers commercial. But I thought this was funny. And I don't know how I used it, but evidently my kids did tell me it was, that was not what it meant. So anyway, but I do love using it. So yeah, but anyway, so where was I? Okay, finished objects. So those are it. The, you know, the hat and the mofo. So let's see what's next. Okay. Finished. No, works in progress. Sorry. We've already done finished object, huh? A friend of mine wanted a Katniss cow. If you're a Hunger Games movie fan, then you know who Katniss is. And maybe you know about the cow. She sent me some yarn, which I thought, whoa, no way was I going to try to knit with this. You see, it's not even twisted. I wonder if it's yarn that was meant for weaving. But I said, okay, I probably can work with it crochet. So this is the top part. This is the cow part. Cow. Yeah. Didn't want to get any makeup on it. And I forgot what this stitch is. I crocheted this with a clover 10 millimeter. And popcorn stitch. That's what it's called. Popcorn stitch. So this is the cow part. And sure, you're gonna have to forgive me for wearing your stuff before you get a chance to. And I like just the top being a cow, actually, but it gets more of it will get connected, which this is the bottom wrap. It only goes through, you only put it through one armhole. The other arm is totally free. So I'm curving this. This will be the armhole here. And I think that's the back. Yeah. Yeah. Yep, this is the front. But for the yarn to be as splitty as it was, I tried to, you know, do a very loose stitch as opposed to tightening it up. I'm working, and this is actually two balls of yarn, two separate balls of yarn. So initially it would have just been four threads, you know, and I'm getting eight threads here. So, this should be finished by the end of the week. I'll have to do the blocking part. And get it off to you, Cheryl. So, that was one thing. I was a little skeptical, a little scared, you know, when you're doing things for others. And let me show you what I won. I know I'm breaking this up, but I'm just talking here. This was in the same bag that I got from Joanne's. It says, knitting, procrastinating. It's It's a verb to defer all other activities besides knitting. I got that at Aunt Joanne's. So, yeah. But I won something from Queen Nadira, who is in New York and has a podcast. And she, wonderful crocheter. She's a wonderful crocheter. I think she is also knitting socks on the 9-inch circular. So we kind of share that vibe for a moment. She is the queen of deals, I tell you that. She finds some deals on yarn and just good stuff. So, but I want, and I can't even remember what I did to win or what she had us do, but this is a little bag. Yeah, it's nice. And, you know, she's sitting with a little card. And stitch markers, ring stitch markers. Can you see them? No, the light. This light, I'm sorry. I'm sorry about the light, you guys. I have set a goal for myself to learn Pinnacle editing software. Yeah, I have. I've signed up for online classes, and I'm going to see how that works, and hopefully my lighting and sound and all that stuff, hopefully I can wrap my mind around it. But thank you, Queen Nadira. I appreciate that. Like I said, that was in the same bag, so that's what made me think of it. I know this should be when I talk about acquisitions, and I do have acquisitions. I do. So next. Oh, I can't really show you that one yet. I did finish the historical shawl that I was working on for another friend who has a book. Is it a book or a play? I think it's a book that's coming out in over the summer, and she wanted to replicate some of the items in the book. So, you know, she asked me to make her shawl. I hope it works. I hope it works. So next, we're gonna go with boom sakalaka, boom sakalaka, boom sakalaka. That really dated me, didn't it? Mm-hmm. Yeah. If you attended an all-black high school or HBCU, probably back in the 70s or 80s, you heard, well, not boom sakalaka, but it was boom shakalaka, boom shak. Remember that? Okay. Okay, if you don't, that's okay. I know most of the podcast generation out there is a lot younger than I am. So anyway, this was my first attempt at sock making using these DPNs. I have not done or touched these socks probably since the first time I showed them to you. I was determined that these sticks and string would not defeat me. I do not enjoy working with these. I was working with the DPN method, or I guess I should say four, because I used the fourth one to knit on. But I don't want to finish these, and I'm not, but I am going to retry it. I am waiting on, and these are only, I think, 4 or 5 inches. I'll tell you in a minute. 5 inches. I'm going to get some metal ones, and I'm waiting to receive some metal ones that are about 6 inches long. So, I don't know that it's going to make a difference. I know I was watching earlier, yesterday, I think it was yesterday, I was watching Vegas Dealer's podcast, which her podcast is it called Vegas Dealer? No. The Limitless Crafter. I know that's her Etsy shop. And that may be the name of her podcast. But her name is Kina, and she goes by the handle of Vegas Dealer. So she encouraged me to don't give up on the deep ends. But this will be frogged. This one will be frogged. These are wooden knit picks. And I'm sure I didn't have any problem per se knitting on them. I kind of felt they were too short though, and kept kind of jabbing me in my hand. I am not sure of the relationship that straights, but not, these are not straights, but DPNs should have in relation to hand size. But yeah, it just kept annoying me by sticking me in my palm. And I found them fiddly as hell. Yeah, I did. So anyway, these won't be. I will give it another try. I will. I promise I will. So that's on the sock front. Now, I did order, if you know, if you watch my previous podcast, you know that I ordered some 9-inch circs, right? And I was going to do two at a time on 9-inch circs. Well, after getting so far on this, yeah, please give me some credit here. I got the heel, and I'm in the process of reducing the stitches. Heel and gusset are there. So, I like these. I like these a lot. And I never did change over. Of course, this is all I know, so I didn't change over to DPNs. I've seen some sock knitters will change. I think when they get to the heel and gusset, will change over to DPNs. But I not knowing any better, I worked right on through. But I think what I'm going to do, because I'm not even sure this sock is going to fit comfortably on my leg, I think this is going to be a framed sock. Remember I said, I can see a wall of framed socks, about 10 in white frames, you know, or maybe black and white frames or something. Something kind of cottagey looking, or something that's kind of quirky in a minimalist contemporary decor. And but anyway, getting back to the sock, I don't know that it will fit. I think this was either a 64 or 68 cast on, and this is the vanilla latte sock. And I know I probably should have the pattern to tell you the name of the designer, but it's not in here. But it's on my project page on Ravelry. But or you can, you know, go to the pattern and search vanilla latte sock. But this is it, and I'm pretty pleased with what I did. I'm not sure if those stripes should be more aligned. Maybe they should be. I don't know. But I like that. And when I cast on the second sock, which I am nowhere near, this is the second sock, but this is 74 stitches. 74, maybe 78, somewhere in the 70s. It's the larger size. And I just really wanted to compare them. Maybe I'm being a little too analytical about it, but I just wanted to compare the 64 stitches without completing both socks at the same time, the same size, and having them not fit as a pair. Yeah, I could still frame them, but if I'm going to knit a second one, I may as well get some glean some knowledge from it. So that's what I'm trying to do with the difference in the sock. And I enjoy, like I said, these are, you know, knitting on these 9-inch circs is, I find it a breeze compared to those DPNs. So, let me get a sip. I'm drinking coffee. Let me get a sip. My throat is feeling dry. Okay. So, that's it on my boom sock-a-lock-a front. And I'll tell you what I got coming up. Okay, actually forgot a work in progress that I want to show you, which is, now this is very different. Very, very different. Well, I am working on sneaker slippers. And again, for another friend. And I'm, darn it. Yeah, got the picture in here, got the pattern. Kind of crumpled up. So, this was a challenge, a little bit, or I'll say I learned something from it. You know, learning to knit in the oval. That's coming out. And, you know, when I say knit in the oval, you, not knit, crochet in the oval, you crochet on both sides of your starting chain. So that was, a learning curve. And, other than that, it's just real interesting to see how this is going to come together. This is the sole, of course. This is the bottom. And yeah, I think you can see it. This is the inside. Now, I want you to see this. The person wears the same size as I do. And you see how much longer? Can, yeah. See how much longer this sole is over the other? Well, I had another pair of these, and I just kept thinking, this, I don't know that this is gonna draw up. It just didn't feel right. So I decided to re-knit it, re-crochet it. So I took, this is a do-over here, because I had gotten this far on a pair that looked like this. It's two soles that I put together is what I'm doing here. And it's a paid pattern, so I don't want to talk too much about how she can, how it's constructed. But it is two soles to sew together. And so this one is the do-over. This is the original. And which I will undo this and redo it. And I can't think of what my error was. Somewhere I was just putting in too daggone many stitches. So that's what was happening. And so this is the correct size. And this fits me well with the little toe room. So, Kit, if you're watching, they're coming. They are coming. They are coming. So that's my other work in progress that I forgot to mention. But let me tell you what I got started. I have been looking at this pattern for months and months and months. And Craftsy finally marked it down, not just the pattern, but the kit, to like $14. And I was like, yeah, I got this. And it is the Architecture Shawl. And it is by Jennifer Weissman. So, and it came with this Cloudborne yarn. Cloudborne, I think is the name of it, Heather. Yarn. And I saw that the grocery girls, who are doing the little series for the Craftsy channel, mentioned the Cloudborne. And I've been noticing it in quite a few of their other pattern kits. And I haven't gotten very far. I don't even know if I got enough to really show you or to say I'm starting. But this is where I'm at. I just did the cast on and maybe a few rows. And, yeah, it does have a halo. I'm not sure that I like halos yet. I think this is will be the yarn that has the most... No, it won't. I take that back. I did work with... create a scarf that had halo on it. A lot of halo. And I don't like the scarf after I finished it. But I don't think I like the yarn either. But I hope this is different. I'm looking forward to this. The other one was acrylic. I can't think what fiber this is. Let's see if I have the bob. And yes, I do. The fiber is fine Highland wool, 100%. So I'm hoping that this will, turn out like in the picture. So I started that. I couldn't resist. I loved this shawl for a long time looking at it. I've seen it on Ravelry as well as Craftsy. And evidently it must have been too expensive for me to consider getting. But it was marked down. And, so that's a good thing. The other thing I'm getting ready to start. Oh, and you've seen this yarn before. I don't know if I have the other one down. You've seen this yarn before in the last podcast acquisition, or maybe January's. And I'm gonna make a poncho for my daughter, and it has cables in it, so that'll be my first time cabling. So it is a Lion Brand pattern too. Oh, hoo hoo hoo. I can't think of it, and I don't have it in the bag, which I need to do. I need to correct that. So, but yeah, I'm getting ready to start a poncho, and it's with this. It's a Vanish Choice Lion Brand. So, I got it in a very big bag here. I'll show you. The bag says, "This will be my year." Sometimes the universe can't take a joke, huh? But that's what the bag says. This will be my year. So, what else do I have to share with you? I think that's it. I know as soon as I upload this, I'll think of, I should have said X, Y, and Z. But anyway, some podcasts that I have been enjoying. Yolanda at Happy Knits did a awesome tutorial of toe-up socks two at a time. I watched it and got jitters. I thought, can I do that? Oh my gosh. Of course, she made it look effortless. So, but I am going to try to do that. I wanted to get to it this month, but I think I won't. I hope to do it by early April. And then I also wanted to cast on a sock loom. And that'll probably be early April as well. So maybe, hopefully, that will, next podcast, you'll see at least something. A start, if not halfway. If not a mofo, okay? So thank you, Yolanda, for that wonderful, wonderful, encouraging video I do. I also have been checking out Vegas Dealer. I mentioned her earlier. Oh, and I got one of her bags. My architecture shawl is living in one of the Limitless Crafters project bags. I love that. I love it. Mm-hmm. Love the fabric. Use it. But anyway, it's in there. But I've been checking out her podcast. She's a what you see is what you get kind of woman. I like that. So her name is Kina. So I've been checking her out and digging her, and ended up subscribing to her channel. So, but she does shoot straight from the hip on, and she effortlessly, there's that word again, effortlessly seams her knitting and sewing life with her opinions on what's going on. She doesn't preach. She's not a soapboxy type of person, but it just kind of glides right through, and you think, oh, that's who she is. Okay, cool. So anyway, I've been watching her, and another one that I have enjoyed, and I don't know why. I remember watching one podcast. She was at the Rhinebeck Festival, but I didn't realize, it didn't dawn on me until I had watched a couple of her podcasts, that that's who she was, and she was going around at Rhinebeck interviewing people about their sweaters. And that's Christy Glass. She is doing a series on men who knit, and I love it. I think she calls it Manch, M-A-N-C-H, Manch. But I have been introduced to some wonderful people, and interesting, and I love her interview style. You know, she just kind of wants to know how men, how that individual she's interviewing got started knitting, if they got any blowback for it, mainly as it is a women's industry. And also, then she has at the very end, she closes out with a series of 5 questions. Just real quick answers, top of your head, you know. And I like it. It's a lot of energy. I appreciate that. I like that. I dig it. So anyway, Christy Glass. So if you need something very interesting to watch, watch her interviews on Men Who Knit. And then I've been watching... this, which I think is very new. I don't know how many episodes. I've watched 2 or 3, but it's the skein. See, whatever I want to say is always the opposite. I want to say skein, but it's skein. Skein game? Skein. Anyway, skein game. Skein, skein, skein game. S-K-E-I-N game, okay? I have to hear someone else say that word for me to know how to say it correctly, because what I want to say, I think I want to say skein, skein, yeah, so skein, skein, skein. Anyway, whatever I want to say is usually the opposite. So but yeah, another, I've only watched a couple of her yeah, about 2 maybe 3 of her of the podcast on her channel. But you may want to check her out again. I think she's just what you see is what you get kind of person. She's also a person that seems to be very open and honest about her disability as it relates to her craft. And I believe very strongly in art and craft and making as it relates to well-being. I didn't say good health, I said well-being, and because well-being encompasses something larger, you know. So anyway, but yeah, check her out. And then another podcast, and I just wrote down the name, I should have wrote down actually where they're located, but it's called Cambornia, K-A-M-M-E-B-O-R-N-I-A, Cambornia podcast. And I think she said Cambornia is a word where all that means kind of where all things are possible. It's her and her partner, a woman and her partner, and I can't think of their names. I apologize for that. But especially since I'm talking about it and I wrote it down as a note. But they don't always speak English, but even when they're speaking their Scandinavian tongue, they do English subtitles. And but it's something about the beauty of her podcast that I enjoy. They show the landscape. They're there on the ocean, and rocks, and it just seems, they just make it seem like this cold weather place is just magical. And it kind of zens me out and makes me feel very peaceful. And so check them out. Kammeboronia podcast. Kammeboronia. So yeah, those are the podcast I've been kind of binging on, I guess, a little bit, or just have caught my attention. Yeah, but I was telling you that I do believe strongly in craft and healing. And, oh, I'm going to talk a little bit about that. And then I'm going to show you some older, small mixed media art quilts that I made. I realized that I've only shown the ones that I have hanging on my dining room wall. And really not a close-up, but you can get an idea of how I like to play with fabric. And I'll do that. I'll close out with that. And after I kind of share, get a little personal, more personal, not that my knitting and crocheting and quilting are not personal, but a little bit more personal. Like I said, I have pulmonary hypertension, and I've struggled with lung disease. I had asthma as a child, but you know, who doesn't? Living in the Ohio Valley, which is where Louisville is situated, and a lot of pollution from around the country, especially the Northeast, settles in here. Not only, and also what we produce, yeah. And when I was a little bit more active, in the community, I will tell you that we had pollution. I had attended meetings on pollution that seems to be in more areas than others. And we had pollution coming as far away from Connecticut and Delaware, settling in this area. And there's a way. Each chemical, I know you didn't ask for this, but it's something that triggered me as I'm talking. Each chemical has a trace number on it, which I found fascinating. So if they do a capture here in the valley and analyze it and look at weather patterns and things like that, they can tell what plant is producing this pollution. And so I did learn that. That's one of the things that has stuck with me from that time. And anyway, and I had an interest in it because of my history with lung disease. But in my 20s, I was finally after having series of bronchitis and pneumonia. Just maybe I would say from the time I was 18 to my mid-20s, I just had constant, what felt like to me, constant hospitalizations because of my pneumonia. And finally, and I'm living life through all of this. I'm living life and doing my thing and feeling invincible like any young person would. So I was diagnosed with sarcoidosis, and I was treated for that for many, many years until probably the mid to late 90s, where a biopsy showed that the sarcoidosis was not there. And sarcoidosis is one of those mystery diseases, yep. Affects a lot of in those days, data and studies show that it affected a lot, primarily black women in the South. So, no, there was not a lot of research on it, just to be honest. So, but since then, research has improved, and still don't know why. Now they just say African Americans are more prone to it. But I have met a couple of, you know, non-African Americans who have sarcoidosis. Anyway, they say it's in remission, you know, it's, but it left scar tissue and thickening in my lungs, and I have something called bronchiectasis, which I don't get too technical, but basically my pulmonary hypertension developed as a result of that, and it is where my lungs do not carry enough oxygen. And I was diagnosed correctly with that in 2004. And, you know, it kind of shook me up, but I have a great pulmonary doctor who has stabilized me, but I seem to be in the last year since I've gone through chemo and radiation, which was very devastating on me in terms of my lung health. I seem to have, I'm increasing again in bronchitis and pneumonia and hospital stays. And so that's where I'm at. And that's why it's difficult to, or I found it difficult in the last month to make a podcast. This is my fourth attempt. Fourth. So you know I love you, right? Yeah. And I've decided to, I probably won't talk about this much anymore on my podcast, but I thought, well, maybe I should, you know, just kind of let people know, hey, I'm still here. So I thought April 1st, I'm going to start a Ravelry group and try to also participate in more of the forums there, especially of the podcasts that I really enjoy and connect with. But I find them just about all interesting. But no, I can't participate in 100 forums. No. I'll start. I have a trouble remembering who I am, let alone who you are, okay? But I thought having a Ravelry group is more of a personal, a little bit more personalized communication, and it'll help me better identify people better. So, and have a conversation more, so, as opposed to doing it in the comments below. I can't say that I'm going to be real good about show notes, but I know everybody is Google savvy these days. But if it's something you want to just ask, feel free to hit me up on Ravelry. That's probably the best way. And I check it at least, I sit down at least, I had to limit myself on Ravelry, but I do sit down and have a good long time, at least once, twice a week, where I check and see what's going on with the forums and looking at patterns. So that is it. So let me show you my quilts, and I'm going to let you go. And again, I appreciate you. If you've gotten this far, love you. Sending you love. Yep. So let me know about the buttons too, you know, on the sweater. But I hear my husband upstairs. This is a quilt I made to honor, not to really honor. I was feeling nostalgic about the house that I spent a lot of time in growing up, and that's my great grandmother's house. And it was finally torn down, and it sat empty for so many years. And I don't know if you have this kind of family, but nobody was interested in maintaining it because it needed a lot of work, and my father was offered the house if he paid the taxes on it, which were I'm learning this all after the fact, not when it's happening, but anyway, I won't go there. But he wasn't interested, and so the person that who inherited the house just let it go, and it was eventually condemned and torn down. Well, nobody told me, and I rode by one day, and the house where I grew up was an empty lot, and I just wanted to. And let me tell you, before that happened, I was having lunch with a friend who I was talking about. I was just talking about experiences that I had growing up with my great-grandmother, and that the house was empty, blah, blah, blah. And he said, let's go get the numbers off the house. And I was like, yeah. And he was like, now. So I do have the metal house numbers. They are somewhere in here. They're somewhere in here. And off the house. And I love them. And not sure. I have still not done anything with them other than keep them in, you know, stored. But I do love them, and I'm glad I have them. And so this little is just a collage quilt. This is my great-grandmother in 1945. And a picture of her. And it just says 725 West St. Catherine Street. And her name was Willie Pearl. Well, on this side, Willie Pearl. And so I was playing here, and the fabric here is painted. This is a commercial fabric. But this fabric here was painted with fabric paint and then stamped on with fabric paint using different stamps, and then I stitched in circles, which is one of my favorite things to do. Free motion, I think this one was free motion quilted, just round and around, and and then I used a little tiny sleeve to hang it. So I did this one in 2008. Yeah, so, I was very fortunate. She died when I was in my 20s, and to have my great-grandmother still alive, up until my mid-adult, was a blessing. It was just a blessing to me. I have one more quilt that I wanted to show you, which is not here, it's upstairs. So with that, I'm going to let you go, and hope you subscribe or like me, or if you've made it this far, do one or the other. I appreciate it. So in love and in peace. Bye-bye.